I'm sorry, Heidi. I'm doing the best I can. Heidi, stop picking on it.
Well, we couldn't make you one either.
Heidi, be nice. We're all under pressure.
Pressure? I'm not feeling any pressure. Do you feel any pressure?
I don't know. Yeah, you're in line.
Hey, we're not going to win, are you, sing this way? Come on, kids. We got a show to do.
This time, it's the big time. In a short time, we can be
the cherry on the top of the sundae, the shining star on top of the tree.
So better grab it with your both hands. That great moment arrives, 'cause this time it's the big time. It's the big time of our lives.
This time it's the extra, it's the special, it's the plus. This time we won't say those lucky bastards. This time those lucky bastards are us.
Mainly something.
Farewell to the small times, to the flea bags and the dives, 'cause this time is the big time. It's the big time of our
Oh,
to the old girl now, fellow.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 1987 Fascinatin Rhythms Song Leader Representatives.
Delta.
Phi Kappa Psi.
Alpha Epsilon Phi. Phi
Singers. We have Catherine Tischner, Roberta Duchak, Colleen McCarthy, Andrew Redeker, and Matthew Kellogg. And our IU Sing Orchestra, under the baton of Richard Beaver.
For the 15th consecutive year, Student Foundation is sponsoring this campus-wide competition. The entire production is conceived, directed, and performed by students, and is second only to Spirit of Sport All-Nighter in student participation.
Each act is an original production put together by a housing unit. They compete in three divisions. Division A is for acts consisting of 1 to 60 members with a storyline. Division B is for acts with more than 60 members and a storyline. And Division C is the medley division. It has an unlimited number of people, and it's a medley of songs with no storyline.
So without further ado, let us welcome Delta Zeta and Phi Delta Theta in Who Would Be Your Neighbor?
Woo!
Thank you.
Zeta Beta Tau, Strange Experience.
Someone to hold you to close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair and ruin your sleep. And make you aware of being alive. Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short and put you through hell. And give you support for being alive. Being alive.
Everything seems lovely when you start to roll. good you'll be saying when you are far from home. Mammy, Mammy, the sun shines east, the sun shines west.
If that's a possibility, then the intentional infliction of mental disturbance is something that is very real. High schoolers get in the lowdown on the law. This class at Andover High School in Broomfield Hills is called You and the Law.
I know some people who have been pulled over by police officers, and we figure it's a good thing to know our rights.
My father's a lawyer, and I kind of want to continue the career maybe.
The Michigan Law-Related Education Project has been encouraging school districts to adopt such courses since 1982.
As far as attendance at our conferences, requests for information, they've tripled since I've been on the job.
So far, 75 Michigan school districts have been trained to implement law-related courses. The Michigan Department of Education is recommending law be a required course for ninth graders. In Broomfield Hills schools, it already is.
I believe that by the time everybody graduates, they should understand their rights and responsibilities and understand how society works.
Sigma Alpha Epsilon in a clash of cultures.
I hear bells in the summer night, distant bells that no one hears. I hear moonlight softly chiming and clang of mighty climbing. I hear the bells on a river dock. I hear the bells in the city clock too. Truly I do. I could show you sad, come along with me, hear the world with my own ears, hear the starlight faintly tinkling, and the ping of candles twinkling. I hear the bells in a summer shower, not just the bells on the quarter hour. If you're in need of a world that can shine, come and hear mine. Call me mad, well, of course you will. Put me under lock and key. I'll hear music where I'm rooming, like the bong of roses blooming. I hear the bells in a summer shower, bells seem to call from each flower stall too. Truly they do. I could show you others don't take time to see. When I feel that special jingle and the river starts to tingle, I hear the bells that I love so much. Bells I can smell, I can taste and touch. If you're in need of a world that can shine, shine.
Center presenting Reed Cinema presents Splicing
It Up. Fresh young girls for this next number, but we couldn't find any. So we got the talented, charming, and effervescent Heidi and her plain little sister Leanne.
Thanks.
Listen as these two young girls wish for a life that doesn't include their bushy stage mother in The Mama Was Married.
If Mama was married, we'd live in a house as private can be. Just Mama, three ducks, five canaries, a mouse, two monkeys, one father, six turtles, and me. If Mama was married, if Mama was married, I'd jump in the air and give all my toe shoes to you. I'd get all these hair ribbons out of my hair, and once and for all, I'd get Mama out too. If Mama was married. Mama, get out your white dress. You've done it before without much success. Mama, Godspeed and God bless. We're not keeping score. What's one more or less? Oh, Mama, say yes and waltz down the aisle you may. I'll gladly support you. I'll even escort you. And I'll gladly give you away. Oh, Mama, get married today. If Mama was married, there wouldn't be any more. Let me entertain you. Let me see you smile. I will do some kicks. Woo-hoo! I will do some tricks. Sing out, Louise. Smile, baby. Mama, get out your white dress. We aren't the Lunds. I'm not Benny Bright. Mama, I'll buy you the rice. If only this once, you wouldn't think twice. It could be so nice if Mama got married today. But Mama gets married and married and married and never gets carried away. Oh, Mama.
In After the Honeymoon.
Whee! Woo!
Fascinating rhythm, you got me on the go. Fascinating rhythm, I'm all a quiver.
What a mess you're making. The neighbors want to know why I'm always shaking.
Like a
each morning I get up with the sun to find at night no work hasn't done well.
Once it didn't matter, but now you do it wrong. When it starts to matter, I'm so unhappy.
Won't you take the day off, decide to run along somewhere far away off, make it snappy. Oh, how I long to be the one I used to be. That's an eight rhythm, why don't you stop a-picking on me? Each morning I wake up with the sun.
Gathered with us tonight some of the brightest talent in music today. All have donated their time and expertise, and we are indeed very grateful. First judge I'd like to introduce is a great former assistant director of choral activities at Lafayette Jefferson High School, Lafayette, Indiana, Mr. Kevin Butler.
Current head of the music department at Lafayette Jefferson High School, Lafayette, Indiana. Former director of the award-winning NHS Singers, Noblesville High School, Noblesville, Indiana, Miss Lynn Leupold. Member of the music education faculty at the School of Music at Indiana University, Bloomington, and the current conductor of the All-University Women's Chorus, Mr. Darrell Bailey.
Professor of Theater and Drama at Indiana University and the current choreographer for the Indiana Pace Mace, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jim Canaday. The vocal director of Lawrence North High School, Indianapolis, Indiana, and a member of the 1981 IU Sing production staff, Ms. Cheryl Patchen.
Current choral director at Belmont High School, Decatur, Indiana, a former member of the Singing Hoosiers, please welcome Miss Sarah Mitchell Doonan. Ladies and gentlemen, our 1987 IU Sing judges. And to begin the second half of our show, we have Foster Quad in IU.
We are.
A book report on Peter Rabbit.
A book report on Peter Rabbit.
the stupid rabbit who took vegetables from other people's gardens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 83 to go.
The name of the book about which this book report is about is Peter Rabbit, which is about this rabbit. I found it very, I like the hardware. It was a, it reminded me of Robin Hood. And the part where Little John jumped from the rock to the sheriff of Nottingham's back. And then Robin and everyone swung from the trees in a sudden surprise attack. And they captured the sheriff and all of his goods, and they carried him back to their camp at the woods. And the sheriff was guest at their dinner, and nobody wriggled away, and he sounded the call, and his men rushed in, and the arrows flew. Peter Rabbit did sort of that kind of thing too.
The other people's name was McGregor. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23,
In examining a work such as Peter Rabbit, it is important that the superficial characteristics of its deceptively simple plot should not be allowed to blind the reader to the more substantial fabric of its deeper motivations. In this report, I plan to discuss the sociological implications of family pressure so great as to drive an otherwise moral rabbit to perform acts of thievery which he consciously knew were against the law. Roles of Mr. McGregor in Farmer and Humanitarian. Peter Rabbit is established when he started as a benevolent.
If I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all. I'll get a fresh start tomorrow, and it's not due till Wednesday, so I'll have all of Tuesday unless something should happen. Why does this always happen? I should be outside playing, getting fresh air and sunshine. I work best under pressure, and there'll be lots of pressure. I should start rendering lecture. I should start writing now. But if I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all.
The name of the rabbit was Peter. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Ah! Down came the staff on his head, smash! And Robin fell like a sack full of lead, crash! The sheriff laughed and he left him for dead. Ah! But he was wrong.
35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Just then an arrow flew in.
Whing!
It was the sign for the fight to begin.
Sing!
And then it looked like the sheriff could win. Ah, but not for long. Away they ran, just like rabbits who run along. As you can tell from the story of Peter Rabbit, which this report is about.
How do they expect us to write a book report of any quality? Just today. How can they conspire to make life so miserable and so effectively in so many ways?
And not to mention the extreme pressure exerted by him on his constant rivalry with Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail.
That easy, stupid book about the stupid rabbit who took vegetables from other people's garden.
Home. The end.
94, 95, the very, very, very end.
Amen.
A book report on Peter Rabbit. welcome Alpha Delta Pi and Pi Kappa Alpha in. May all your dreams come true.
Your smile has really grown me. This is not like me at all. I never thought I'd know the kind of love you've shown me. Now, no matter where I am, no matter what I do, I see your face appearing like an unexpected song, an unexpected song that only we are hearing. I don't know what's going on, can't work it out at all. Whatever made you choose, as though you couldn't bear to lose me. Now, no matter where I am, no matter what I do, I see your face appearing like an unexpected song, an unexpected song. My heart would
start to smile again until I smile at you.
In the bedroom when it suddenly came clear that at last I don't remember that at one time you were here. All those things that used to haunt me like your row behind the door, for the first time I don't notice that they're not here anymore. And I don't remember summer, I do not remember fall, so it's possible December never happened after all. Did we trim the tree together? I can't get the image through, 'cause I don't remember Christmas and I don't remember you. Later on, to my astonishment, I did not feel a tug when I walked into that living room and saw that sheepskin rug. All the pesky little echoes, they're all gone without a trace. It was good to know I could grow unaccustomed to your face. And I don't remember Easter or the rainy day we met. Did we really have some good times? Come on, tell me, I forget. Did I think that you were springtime? It's all vanished in the blue, 'cause I don't remember Christmas and I don't remember you. If she wants to leave you a letter, says a practical voice in my head. Any sensible man would forget her. And Bermuda is a blur, and I'm not the kind to waste time over things that never were. Were you really my obsession till our ship of pleasure sank? No, I guess I must have dreamt you, 'cause the whole year is a blank. And I don't remember crying, I cannot recall your touch, 'cause I've never been so stupid as to open up so much. Did I really say I need you? No, the words don't ring true, 'cause I don't remember laughing, and I don't remember crying, and I don't remember wanting, and I don't remember need. I do not remember April, I do not remember Tuesday, and I don't remember Christmas, and I don't remember you.
Let's welcome Alpha Epsilon Phi and Phi Kappa Psi.
Make the moments fly on. winter. I'll forget you by next year, some year. Though it's hell that I'm going through, some Tuesday, Thursday, April, August, autumn, winter, next year, some year. Time heals everything. Time heals everything. But loving you, April, August, autumn, winter, next year, some year, time heals everything. Time heals everything. But
good afternoon. Welcome to the Indiana University Student Foundation Brown Bag Lunch and Discussion Forum. Today's topic will be Morality in the United States of America, : Jive Talk and Lingo, 1917 to the present day. Some of you will be grossly disgusted at the immoral language you are about to hear. Some of you will only pretend to be grossly disgusted. But I digress. Maestro, if you please. For some it's grass, for some it's coke, for some it's powder, for some it's smoke. Everybody today is turning on. For some it's dust, for some it's wheat, for some it's acid, for some it's meat. Everybody today is turning on. Time was when if a fellow felt depressed, he simply got it off his chest by calling on a preacher, talking to his teacher, coughing up a half a buck to see a double feature. But now it's pills, and now it's pot, and now it's poppers, and God knows what. Snip, swig, pop, and your cares are gone. Everybody today is turning on. The simple life it must have been when smoke was Lucky's and high was gin. One pink lady and how it turned them on. When junk was trash and speed was swift and glue was pasted instead of sniffed. Coke and aspirin and wow, it turned them on. Those days whenever folks were feeling low, they knew that they could get a glow. And prayed home steady, laughing at the capers. Mutt and Jeff were cutting in the Sunday funny papers. But now it's and down it goes, around your windpipe and up your nose. Sniff, swig, puff, and your cares are gone. Everybody, the day is turning on.
remember when high was up and kicks were tame, when amyl nitrate was some guy's name.
Pulling hands and smooching was turning on.
Horse was ride, roach was bugs, and French connections were foreign plugs.
Driving to Eddie Duchin was turning on.
Those days when if your nerves were kinda shot, instead of going right to pop, you prayed to hold them steady, kept a Bible ready,
took advice from Rabbi Weiss or Mary Baker Eddy.
But with the world so much a whisk, now can a whiskey be cannabis? Sniff, swig, pop, and your cares are temporarily gone.
Everybody today is turning right and left, those joints keep burning.
Tax-free loot some pushers earning, kids know how now daddy's learning.
Everybody today is turning on.
Hey, remember when hash was fried and tea was brewed, when someone pushing was merely rude, when once a week you cut the grass and too much acid just gave you gas.
Snip, sweep, pop, and your cans are temporarily gone.
Everybody today is puffing into fudge, look what they're stuffing.
Hold it, Ma, don't touch that muffin. God knows what your grandpa's snuffing.
Everybody today is turning on.
Cheap beer. minibus from Dan Ken. If the hefty auger can. If the lead for some pure lesbian can. Baby, you can
get cool, boy. Got a rocket in your pocket. Keep coolie cool, boy. Don't get hot, man, you got some high times ahead. Take it slow, and daddy-o, you can live it up and die in bed. Boy, crazy boy, stay loose, boy. Turn off the juice, boy. Come and go, but not like a yo-yo schoolboy. Just play it cool, boy. Real cool.
I'm singing in the rain. Just sing.
What do you mean you cut my number? I'm a song leader. You can't cut my number. Play it.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 58th annual IU Sing Fascinatin' Rhythm. I'm Ken Derby.
I'm Leanne Sandel.
I'm James Moore.
And I'm Heidi Dittmar. We are your hosts for this evening of entertainment. Lending our support this evening is our backup singers, Colleen McCarthy, Roberta Duchak, Andrew Redeker, Matthew Kellogg, and Catherine Tishner, and our IU Sing Orchestra under the baton of musical director Richard Beaver.
For the 15th consecutive year, Student Foundation is sponsoring this campus-wide competition. The entire production is conceived, organized, and performed by IU students and is second only to Spirit of Sport All Nighter in student participation.
IU Sing consists of individual acts, each presented in an original manner by the housing units. They compete in three divisions. Division A is for those acts with 1 to 60 members and a storyline. Division B is for acts with more than 60 members and a storyline. And Division C is the medley division. It has any number of participants and has no storyline.
So without further ado, let us begin tonight's show by welcoming Alpha Phi and Kappa Sigma in Showtime.
The Flintstones, but they're a modern Stone Age family. Bop, from the uptown of Denron, but they're a place right out of history.
That's
right.
We are
the family down the street. Courtesy of friends to be.
Ba-ba-da-wen-yo with the Flintstones. Have a yabba dabba day old time.
Indiana, off to the return to the Broadway stage with her Grammy-nominated LP, The Broadway Album. From that album, Leanne Sandel with Being Alive.
Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair and ruin your sleep and make you aware of being alive. Someone to need you too much. someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short and put you through hell and give you support for being alive. Being alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Stop me with rage. Let me be used. Vary my days. But alone is alone. Not alive. Somebody hold me too close. Somebody force me to care. Somebody let me come through. I'll always be there. As frightened as you of being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Who like it or not will want you to share a little, a lot of being alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Make me confused. Mark me with praise. Let me be used. Vary my days. But alone is alone.
Amen. I'd walk a million miles for one of a smile from my
Delta Upsilon in Will This Ever
Have a Baby, which is all about the joys and sorrows of having a child. In this song, three ladies wait in a doctor's office. A physical education teacher who has been waiting to get pregnant, a 21-year-old student, and a 40-year-old who discovers she is pregnant again. These ladies are meeting for the first time, but they find they have a lot in common in the song, I Want It All. But I always made sure I didn't expect too much. I sat around on my potential, but now that I have heard its news, it's released all these possibilities. All I have to do is choose. I want. I want every known female sensation. I want to be Scarlett O'Hara, Joan of Arc, Lauren McCall. I want it all. Put what I want on this side and what I don't want over here. It was quite a bout, but I worked it out, and now the answer's very clear. I want.
Choose, my friends, and there's some things you gain, but some you lose, my friends. Some truly lovely things,
like what?
Like an overtone of romance, an element of surprise, the things any grown-up practical woman gives up if she. I want.
a dill pickle.
I want a Learjet.
I want a string bikini.
I want the Nobel Prize.
I want it all.
Lambda Chi Alpha in IUopoly.
This name of a puppet was available the second that he called. And all he had to do was yell, "Hey, Mega!" And this dumb hashlinger crawled. For 7 lousy years, I've watched him swear and shove and shove. You. Well, it's gonna be without. I gotta give my life some sparkle and fizz, and think a thought that isn't wrapped up in his. The place that I consider paradise is wherever he ain't, wherever he ain't. No more to wither when he's grouchy and gruff. No more to listen to him bellow and bluff. Tomorrow morning I'll be strutting my stuff wherever he ain't, wherever he ain't. Enough of being bullied and bossed. Ta-ta, I'll be the same and get lost. I walked behind him like a meek little lamb, and had my fill of his not giving a damn. I'll go to Sydney or Ceylon or Siam, wherever he ain't, wherever he with me behaving like a simpering sap. And so I'm looking for a spot on the map. If he's going south, I'm going north. If he's going back, I'm going forth. Wherever he
Delta Gamma and Pi Beta Phi in Getting It Together.
I hear bells in the summer night, distant bells that no one hears. I hear moonlight softly chiming, and the clang of ivy climbing. I hear the bells on the river dock. I hear the bells in the city clock too. Truly I do. I could show you sad. Come along with me, hear the world with my own ears. hear the starlight faintly tinkling, and the ping of candles twinkling. I hear the bells in a summer shower, bells seem to call from each quarter hour to your need of a world that can shine. Come and hear mine. Me under lock and key. I'll hear music where I'm roaming, like the bong of roses blooming. I hear the bells in a waterfall, bells seem to call from each flower stall too. Truly they do. I could show is it wrong to be hearing things others don't take time to see? When I feel that special jingle and the river starts to tingle, I hear the bells that I love so much, bells I can smell, I can taste and touch. If you're in need of a world that can shine, come and hear mine, come and hear mine, come and hear
now. Please welcome Sigma Kappa and Delta Chi in Bohemian Bust.
I hate musicals with children in them, like The Sound of Music, The King and I, and Annie. You'll understand why my favorite number in Annie is when the three villains plot to get rid of that rotten little goody two-shoes.
I remember the way our sainted mother would sit and croon us her lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book.
I know you stack the aces.
You load the dice.
Mother dear, all we know you're down there listening. How can we follow your sweet advice to easy street, easy street, way asleep till noon?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
She
scrounge for three or four bucks while she gets war bucks.
Ah, the little brat! It ain't fair, this here life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady.
Ha ha, to getting more bucks
instead of less.
Ha 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 ha.
Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Callahan.
Give you one guess. Yes. Easy Street.
Welcome Kappa Kappa Gamma and Alpha Tau Omega in K-Tau presents Sounds of the 70s.
Homework.
Yuck.
Rabbit, it's the stupid book about the stupid rabbit who steals vegetables from other people's gardens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 83 to go.
The name of the book about which this book report is about is Peter Rabbit, which is about this rabbit. I found it very, I like the hardware. It reminded me of Robin Hood. And the part where little John jumped from the rock to the sheriff of Nottingham's back. And then Robin and everyone swung from the trees in a sudden surprise attack. And they captured the sheriff and all of his goods, and they carried him back to their camp at the woods. And the sheriff was guessing their dinner at all, but he wriggled away and he sounded the call. And his men rushed in and the arrows flew. Peter Rabbit did sort of that kind of thing too.
The other people's name was McGregor. 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23.
In examining a work such as Peter Rabbit's, it is important that the superficial characteristics of its deceptively simple plot should not be allowed to blind the reader to the more substantial fabric of its deeper motivations. In this report, I plan to discuss the sociological implications of family pressure so great as to drive an otherwise moral rabbit to perform acts of thievery which he consciously knew were against the law. I also hope to the personality of Mr. McGregor in conflicting roles as farmer and humanitarian. Peter Rabbit is established from the start as a benevolent hero. It's
if
only
I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all. I'll get a fresh start tomorrow, and it's not due till Wednesday, so I'll have all of Tuesday unless something should happen. Why does this always happen? I should be outside playing, getting fresh air and sunshine. I work best under pressure, and there'll be lots of pressure if I wait till tomorrow. I should start writing now, but if I start writing now when I'm not really rested, it could upset my thinking, which is not good at all.
The name of the rabbit was Peter. 24, 25,
25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, huh?
Down came the staff on his head, smash! And Robin fell like a sack full of lead, crash! The sheriff laughed and he left him for dead, but he was wrong.
35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
Just then an arrow flew in,
wing!
It was the sign for the fight to begin,
sing!
And then it looked like the sheriff could win, but not for long. Away they ran, just like rabbits who run along, as you can tell from the story of Peter Rabbit, which this report is about.
How do they expect us to write a book report of any quality? How can they conspire to make life so miserable?
And
so effectively, in so many ways.
And not to mention the extreme pressure exerted on him by his deeply rooted rivalry with Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail.
Rabbit is a stupid book about the stupid rabbit who's just vegetable from other people's garden. Home.
The end.
94, 95, the very, very, very end.
Amen.
A book report on Peter Rabbit.
Recognition. He is presently on the board of directors for Indiana University Foundation, and 45 years ago he was chairman of IU Sing. Please make welcome Mr. E.W. Kelly.
I was standing in the bedroom when it suddenly came clear that at last I don't remember that at one time you were here. All those things that used to haunt me, like your role behind the door, for the first time I don't notice that they're not here anymore. And I don't remember summer, I do not remember fall, so it's possible December never happened after all. Did we trim the tree together? I can't get the image through, 'cause I don't remember Christmas and I don't remember you. Later on, to my astonishment, I did not feel a tug when I walked into that living room and saw the sheepskin rug. All the pesky little echoes, they're all gone upon a trace. It was good to know I could grow unaccustomed to your face. And I don't remember Easter or the rainy day we met. Did we really have some good times? Come on, tell me I forget. Did I think that you were springtime? It's all vanished in the blue, 'cause I don't remember Christmas and I don't remember you. If she wants to leave you, well, let her, says a practical voice in my head. Any sensible man would forget her, forget her, forget her. So things do never happen, and Bermuda is a blur. And I'm not the kind to waste time over things that never were. Were you really my obsession till our ship of pleasure sank? No, I guess I must have dreamt you, 'cause the whole year is a blank. And I don't remember crying, I cannot recall your touch, 'cause I've never been so stupid as to open up so much. Did I really say I need you? No, the words just don't reach you, 'cause I don't remember laughing, and I don't remember crying, and I don't remember wanting, and I don't remember needing. I do not remember April, I do not remember Tuesday, and I don't remember Christmas, and I don't remember you.
Welcome Sigma Delta Tau and Chi Phi in both IU
you.
Discovered that most American divorces of middle-aged couples are the result of long-suppressed female desires to swing, steam, pulse, and throb. In this next number, Leanne plays just such a woman shortly after her husband told her that she was going to pot. Watch out, it's Flaming Agnes.
An $85 hat. What do you think of that? 13 feathers of the pigeon family and a bird of paradise plume. I hid this hat for 4 whole years in a great big box at the foot of the bed, right here in this very same room. But now my spouse, it's out of the box, and I'm going to tell you what. If I am going to go to pot, this pot is gonna be hot. Say, who's that racy middle-aged lady peeking underneath her veil? Why don't you know? It's Flaming Agnes. Her husband up and left her. Who's that pale, available matron underneath the peacock's tail? Why can't you guess? It's Flaming Agnes. Emancipated lady used to find her sitting in the kitchen. Mousy Housewife was her name. But the day her husband up and left her, Agnes started to flame. Now they say that nothing can save her, and they blame her husband for the blazing shame of Flaming Agnes. Flirting with the fellas. Did I give enough? Did I give the moment that he needed me. Did I ever turn away? Would I be there if he called, if he walked into my life today? Were his days a little dull? Were his nights a little wild? Did I overstate my plan? Did I stress the man and forget the child? And there must have been a million things that my heart forgot to say. Would I think of one or two if he walked into my life today? Should I blame the times I pampered him, or blame the times I bossed him? What a shame, I never really found the boy before I lost him. Were the years a little fast? Was his world a little free? Was there too much of a crowd, all too lush and loud, and not enough of me? Though I'll ask myself my whole life long, what went wrong along the way? Would I make the same mistakes if he walked into my life today? If that boy with the bugle walked into my life
today. You and Delta Tau Delta in
continuing in our round the world musical cruise. Wayne Hokanukanani sings of his tropical homeland, the land of volcanoes, grass skirts, and lovely young maidens greeting you with a lay.
Make me happy.
Make me feel so fine.
Make me feel so fine.
Tiny bubble.
Tiny bubble. I do to be so black and blue?
No joys for me.
So black and blue. I'm white inside, but that don't help my case.
Don't you know it, brother?
The Love Boat.
We tried to think of a clever intro for this next number, but it's just too confusing. You see, I play this famous newswoman, kind of like Barbara Walters, and I divorce the man that she is married to.
And you believe that?
Yeah. Well, anyway, I am now having trouble with my current boyfriend, so I've come to ask her,
the wife of her ex-husband,
how she keeps her man. Understand? Anyway, it's called The Grass is Always Greener.
But you're Tess Harding, for God's sake. I've never done anything important in my life the way you have. I'll bet your friends are all celebrities. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? You can make a pot roast. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? First you brown an onion. Is your picture up at Sardi's? That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? You can clean an oven. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? First you get the easy up. What's so wonderful? Bet you go to Tisco's. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? you take a Valium, I can see you planning picnics. Oh, that's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? Eating at the White House. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? First they pass the jelly beans.
Oh, the grass is always greener on somebody else's front lawn. Oh, somebody else's wiener always has a lot more relish on.
You save the whales in Newfoundland. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? You can run a household. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? First you have a breakdown. You're always in the magazines. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? You can hold a husband. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? There's more to life than husbands.
I could use a husband.
You can have my husband.
I've already had your husband.
Oh, it makes you kind of teary. Oh, think you're mighty teary. The grass is always greener.
First they sell the Tupperware. The public wants your autograph. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? You raised a teenage daughter. Oh, that's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? First you find her diaphragm.
Oh, the grass is always greener when some other tenant pays rent.
What's so wonderful? You know Rona Barrett. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? First you keep your mouth shut. I'll bet you squeeze the Charmin. Oh, that's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? You can make a headline. That's wonderful.
What's so wonderful? I'd rather have a pot roast.
So go and brown an onion.
Have some peace and quiet.
You've already had my husband.
Oh, everyone's a victim of this document.